First and foremost, I'd like to say that I can't believe that I'm doing this. However, if it wasn't for the goddess herself asking me to do this, I wouldn't be ashamed. I'm very private in nature, so I'm not a very open person like that for everyone.
Well, I appreciate it.
Not a problem. Only for you. The goddess. You tend to do things like that for a goddess. The topic is being single in Memphis. And as a single man in Memphis, I would like to say the things that I encountered from the sisters here would probably be a general problem that's with a lot of sisters dealing with baggage, damaged goods, and honesty. I'm an honest brother. If you ask me a question, I'm going to be honest with you. So I expect the same in return. And there's too many, I don't want to say games, but deceit and honesty, lack of honesty from males and females in Memphis. So I only expect it from the females because I'm sure that they receive it from all the different males in this area.
So what type of lies have you encountered? Like what?
Just very simple ones. To me, I'm very non-judgmental. I don't think people get that. You know, a lot of people say that and then you tell them something and they become judgmental. However, I'm the type of person, I'm very non-judgmental. So a lot of the deceit that I get becomes with prior relationships or with females dealing with other males if they are at the time they were talking. For whatever reason that may happen. But I don't mind though. Be honest with me. That's all I ask for. Any woman has to have a sense of humor. I love to laugh. I love to laugh at myself. That's number one. I will laugh at myself. You have on the yellow bow tie. Yes, I do. If you think it's funny.
It's not funny. You look nice in a yellow bow tie.
Thank you. But you have to be honest, though. I can't stand if I ask you a question for you to be like, I wasn't honest with you because I didn't think you could handle the truth. I don't like that. If I'm asking you a question, I can accept the answer, whether it be good or bad. I'm asking the question because I want to know the honest answer. Sure. I don't want to have to find out in the end that it was something else because I want to build, in terms of building anything, relationship, building that we're in right now, it's a foundation. If the foundation is crap, then the building or whatever structure that you put on is going to be crap. So if you go into a relationship being deceitful about prior relationships, who you've been with, or things that you're doing right now, then it's hard to build a sustainable, stability type of relationship on a false surface like that. So right. The foundation is a lot.
We talked about that kind of the other day when you and I and another brother were sitting down talking about people being deceitful and just kind of, you know, talking about how we're trying to get a person to accept what we can't already accept about ourselves.
Exactly.
You know, so as far as going out with women here in Memphis, like what has been the consensus with some of the mentalities of the women that you've encountered?
They settle too much. I don't want to say it's just Memphis women. I think women in general nowadays, because of the lack of desirable men that we have out here, I'm not trying to put myself on a pedestal, but I just know there's a lot of brothers out here that are not doing what they should be. I think they settle too much. The whole, you know, stability issue of we have children together, or he pays this for me, or he does this for me. To me, when it comes down to a relationship, the overriding factor is happiness and love. If I can't have those in my mate, then why am I truly with you? Trying to stay together for a family and a household, that's cool, but all you're doing is you're raising families and kids to see what a non-loving relationship looks like, which to them becomes standard. So you're doing nothing but perpetuating the cycle of unsuccessful relationships, not loving relationships. Don't settle. If you're not happy with somebody, move on. You can 9 times out of 10 be honest with that person, be like, hey, I'm gonna move on. I do like that we can go out to eat and you can pay for us when we go out to eat, but it's just something that's not right for us relationship wise. And that dude probably gonna be hurt for a little while, but if he really dig you, he probably still gonna take you out to eat a month or two later. You know what I'm saying? So just to be honest, you don't have to settle for that if that's the only part that you desire in that person. Move on to something else until you find that true happiness. You're probably not gonna get 100%, but just being happy, man. Being in love with somebody. Love is not, it's too many women if they start talking about their mate in terms of if I ask them about, you know, prior relationships, previous relationships, or just having conversations with women that are in relationships now. To me, if the first thing that you start off your conversation about is, well, he did, that's, to me, that's just, it's something about that person that you're just settling for. You're not truly happy in that relationship. People not happy in their relationship now.
So you mentioned happiness. What makes you happy? When it comes to man-woman relationships, what are those things that make you happy?
Definitely feeling a sense from whoever it is that I'm dealing with of them wanting me and not needing me. I'm a real giving person, and I struggle with that a lot, because if I encounter a female that I like, or even brothers that I run to on the street that are doing something, I'm a helper. I'm gonna try my best to help you in whatever situation that it is. So I find it kind of hard straddling that line of, does this person have me in their life because they want me in their life? Like, if I wasn't doing the things that I'm providing or whatever I can do, they still want me around. Mm-hmm. Or do they just need me in their life because I'm helping with this or I'm helping with that, or I'm watching your kid, or you know what I'm saying, cutting your grass, you know what I'm saying? That's cool. I don't mind doing that. But if I don't have that sense of that connection of one, I'm all about connection. So the connection is determined based off of conversations. You have to be, the things that make me happy, humor. Is that what you asked me?
We're talking about happiness.
Yeah. Sense of humor, being ability to laugh at oneself, as well as laugh at other people and make jokes. You have to be out of the box as far as your thinking. Somebody that's in the box is not going to make me happy. Have to be intellectual. As Prince Hakeem said, you have to stimulate my loins as well as my mind.
Ah, yes.
So, those things make me happy, man. I'm very, two words to describe me are simply complex.
I like that.
That's the way I describe myself. I'm very simple in nature, but I'm complex on some issues. It doesn't take much. I don't require a lot. Honesty, sense of humor, love to have fun. You have to be a family-oriented type of person. And you have to be active somehow. Socially would be the best, whether it's giving back to the youth or doing something in the community. We have to get back to that as Black people.